A very good morning, dear children. Welcome back to the class. So let's start the class. So children, let's start the class. Today we are going to do revision of chapter Money. In this chapter, what we have studied about different coins and notes of Indian currencies. There are different coins, right? And different notes of Indian currency. Rupees 20, rupees 10. There are different notes as well as different coins. Then number 2, adding small amounts of money. So how to add small amount of money, we have also done in this chapter. Number 3, guessing price of items. To guess, to give your estimate. So what can be the price of a thing, okay? Next, number 4, adding rupee and paise. So as we have done these topics in this chapter, so today we are going to do some of the questions. So let's start. Everyone, take out your maths copy. Here it comes, question number 1. How are the following currencies written in figures? Figures means number, right? So how can you write, children? As it is written, right? So this is written, this is 600 is already in figure, right? So rupees, how can you write? You have to put the symbol of rupees. You have to give the symbol of rupees. And then you can write, we'll write rupees 600. This is how we write in figures. Okay, same applies to next. It is written 10 rupees, which is in words, right? Rupees is in words. Now we will write in figures. So for that we have to put the symbol of rupees. Here it comes. And then we'll write rupees 10. Rupees 10. Okay, next you see. What value can you see in the coin? What value can you see, children? What it is written there? It is written 10, right? So this coin is of rupees 10. So let's write in figures. First you give the symbol of rupees. First you give the symbol of rupees. Then you write 10. Okay? Have you done? Okay, then let's start with our next question, number 2. Next question number 2, what is the total amount in each of the following? So here we are going to do addition of small amount of money, okay? So as I told you that point number 2 is what? Adding small amounts of money. So let's do this. You know how to do, children? Rupees 1, rupee 1 plus rupees 5 plus rupees 10. So what will you get? What will be the answer? 10. Rupees 10 plus rupees 5 is your rupees 15. Then rupees 15 plus rupee 1 will give you rupees 16. So first you give the symbol of rupees and then write 16. Done. Next one, you can see here coins, right? So add this coin, what will you get? Rupees 10 plus rupee 1. Rupees 10 plus rupee 1 makes rupees 11. So let's write. First you give the symbol of rupees. Then you write 11. Done? Okay. So next is what, children? Guessing price of items. Guessing price of items. If you take out page number 29 of your book, children, you can see here, guess the price of these items and ticket. One is done for you, right? This is what? A pot. Now children, this is big in size, right? What can be the price of this pot? Rupees 5 or rupees 50? Yes, depends on the size, right? We'll just assume it on the basis of its size. So this pot can be of rupees 50. Next, you can see this is what? A sharpener. Now what can be the price of sharpener? Rupees 30 is too much for this sharpener, right? So what can be the cost of this sharpener? Rupees 3. What can be the price? Rupees 3. So you can take the correct rupees, okay? Correct money. Next comes, this is chocolate bar, right? Now what can be the price of a chocolate? In 1 rupee, children, in 1 rupee we get a small chocolate, right? Candy. So here, what can be the price of this chocolate? Rupees 10. So we have to guess between two money. So you can see here two amounts are given. So we have to guess between these two rates. Then comes ball. A ball. What can be the price of a ball? Rupees 2 or rupees 20? Rupees 2 is too less for this ball, right? So it will be rupees 20. This is how we guess the price of the items. So the word rate and price, what does it mean? The value of the goods is called the rate or the price. Whatever the value of the good is, we call it as rate or we say price. What is the price of the pot? What is the price of a sharpener? Or we can say what is the rate of pot? What is the rate of sharpener? So these words are used when to know the value of the goods. Okay? Hope it is clear to everyone. Next, you can see adding rupees and money, right? So as we have done now, how to rupee add money. So it is same. Let's see our next question. Question number 3. Rita wants to buy a pencil for rupees 5 and an eraser for rupees 4. How much money does she have? So, how much money does she have? Can you say? She wants to buy your pencil and eraser. So, how much money does she have? How much money should she have? Okay, this, let's make one correction. How much money should she have? So, how much money should she have? Can you say? Everyone try this question first yourself. Then let's do it. Here it comes solution. First, we are going to write cost. We are going to write cost of a pencil. Cost of a pencil. What is the cost of a pencil? Rupees. Give rupees symbol. Then 5. Rupees 5. Right? Next line will be, what is there? Eraser, right? So let's write cost of an eraser. Give the symbol of rupees. Then you write rupees 4. Now children, we have to see that if we buy both the things, what can be the price altogether? Okay, what can be the price altogether? For that we have to do addition. So what we have to write, let's do it. Wait a second. Total money Rita should have to spend is how much money? Let's see, let's count it. First we have to add total money, that is all together we have to find rupees 5 plus rupees 4. Gives us rupees 9, right? So how much money does she should have? She should have at least 9 rupees. She can have more than that also, but she should have at least 9 rupees. So let's write. So Rita should have at least rupees. At least rupees 9. Okay? So, practice these questions at home, children. So, that's all for today. If you find any difficulty while doing this chapter, you can ask me. Thank you so much.